Welcome aboard the Jeannot Sonata C440. My name is Eric Stromberg. This brand new boat is the first boat of the 8th generation of Sonata C models. It's a new generation being launched this year. The Sonata C range was launched 27 years ago, and since then 17,000 Sonata Cs have been built, and we've developed 48 new models. This new model, which was done in development with Jean-Marc Piéton and Philippe Briand, really marks a departure from what we've done in the past. It was developed around three key features, which are redefining of movement on board the boat, the way that we circulate on the boat, the way that we live on the boat, a focus on having a full-featured interior, which is part of the Sonata C DNA, but with a little bit of a twist in terms of its design and some of the key features that we added down below. And the third point was to work on perfecting sailing, to make sure that the boat was a seaworthy and a true sailor's boat, which again has always been part of our DNA. We really wanted to start by redefining the way that you move around on the boat, the whole circulation and the security on board. So we started with a very nice wide foredeck and with wide side decks with a GRP bulwark all the way along that keeps one very secure as you move around the boat. Another key feature was here at the shrouds, where we kept the vertical shroud on the outboard side in order to give the mast maximum stability. And the diagonal shroud we moved inboard. So you can see the passageway here is nice and large, and it gives you a handhold to grab onto as you move around the deck. And as we arrive at the aft part of the side deck, you can see that it inclines and comes all the way down to reach the level of the cockpit, which means you can walk all the way back from the side deck into the cockpit without stepping over the combing, without taking any step whatsoever. So this is really a fantastic feature of the Sonata C440. The ease of circulation extends from the side deck on into the cockpit, where we have a large fold-down swim platform, which gives great access to the sea, easy access up onto the boat. Very wide cockpit. The port side passageway is given over to circulation, while on the starboard side we create a nice little saloon with an L seating area. Rarely have we developed a cockpit table with so many features. At the aft end of the table we have a 12-volt plug, controls for the electrical swim platform, all of the lighting and everything throughout the cockpit, autopilot, tri-data, compass. We even have a very nice view here of the engine panel, which can be easily seen from the helm. Cup holders, handrails, plenty of storage. And at the front end, we even have a removable, portable fridge unit. A lot of thought was given in the cockpit to the life aboard and to the lounging spaces. So one thing we created was an infill piece for a sun deck here inside the cockpit. We have a very nice, very high combing, because we don't have to walk over the combing. We can walk around using the inclined side decks. And so we actually even took this combing here and made it an opening combing. So with a very simple latch, we can open it up, deploy it, and make a very nice, huge lounge space. And we can open up these combings on both sides of the boat. Another key element in the circulation of the boat, the ease of use, the movement that you're carrying on board, is the fact that we have lowered the gooseneck fitting to the minimum level. You can see here, the gooseneck is only just below waist height, which means that it's very easy to access the sail, very easy to open and close the lazy bag. And this type of system, the only thing that changes is that you have to have a very strong bang, so you can see that the boom bang itself is a very large boom bang. But this whole setup here means that the boat gives you additional sail area, your boom is down lower, and great access to the sail handling, putting the sails away, looking at the bag, instead of having to climb up mast and so forth. So this really makes sail handling very different than what we have on our boats today. One of the key features of the new Sonata C range was really to perfect the sailing experience. We started with Philippe Briand, who brought us a design of the hull and appendages that is inspired from the offshore racing world. You can see here with a very large forward section with a full-length chine on the boat. This forward section gives us considerable stability, power, and volume. We also hold the beam very far aft on the boat, which we stabilize then with twin rudders. The twin rudders are mounted on Jeffa roller-bearing, self-aligning bearings, so very light, very controllable boat. We kept an L-keel design, which is really the best keel for offshore use, for cruising and so forth. With that, we added an integrated bowsprit. The integrated bowsprit holds the anchor as far out as possible from nearly vertical bow and allows attachment points for the Code Zero and for the asymmetrical spinnaker. We've also changed the entire rig configuration on this new generation. So we've gone to what we call a cathedral style rigging. In a cathedral rig, you do the twin spreaders, but the upper part of the rig is held by two separate diagonals. What this means is lowering the center of gravity of the rig, thus increasing the stability and the ability to hold sail area into higher wind speeds, but lowering the weight of the rig itself while maintaining a high rigidity of the rig. So it's a great combination, something again coming from the racing world that's found its way into this new generation of boats. We've also, because of the wider hull section here forward, we have a very shallow forward section of the boat. So we have opted to use a retractable bow thruster to make sailing easy. So that's going to eliminate all of the drag that comes from the traditional bow thruster tube. And it also allows the bow thruster to be placed further forward on the boat. So it gives you better lever arm movement. And because it's deeper in the boat, there's no cavitation. So we're putting a lot more of that power into the water. Part of the perfect sailing experience is to have a correctly designed helm station. So a lot of thought went into the ergonomics of the helm station. Because we have this very innovative inclined side deck, it allows us to push the helm station a little bit further outboard. So we have great visibility forward, both seating and standing. We've even brought the GPS screen in here and angled it so that it has the perfect viewing angle when you are driving the boat. We can bring up all the various information here, windlass control, bow thruster control, along with throttle. So everything centralized here. And just forward, a couple of cup holders and the centralized winches, which bring back the main sheet and jib sheet within easy reach of the helm. In our effort to find the very perfect sailing experience, we really wanted to look into different types of programs. One thing that this new, much more powerful, much more stable Philippe Briand design helped us do was to increase the sail area. So we developed a performance version with a much taller rig. We went to a textile rigging in order to keep the center of gravity as low as possible. And with that new rig, we were able to increase the sail area by more than 10%. So somebody who really wants to get out there and sail the boat, have a lot more sensation and so forth, even though as the base version, we are still in some of the best sail area to displacement ratios available on the market, this performance version really takes you over and above for somebody who really, really enjoys getting out there on the water. And the second set of options that we developed around on the boat were options for people who are going to go a little bit further, who are going to travel, spend more time on board, live aboard. Options like davits, water makers, solar panels, full-sized appliances, and lots of storage and comfort options throughout the boat. So the platform that we designed with Philippe Briand, this fantastic new hull form, really allows us to adapt the boat to a variety of different uses and different programs. And the idea was, of course, to perfect everybody's sailing experience. For this new generation of Sun Odyssey, we brought on board a new partner, Jean-Marc Piéton and his design team, who were really able to take a new and fresh look at interior design, and that brought us a lot of great ideas. They were very clearly able to bring innovative concepts such as the central galley, but also keep very very nautical elements such as a real chart table, to take fiddles and handrails and rounded edges, which are part of the nautical tradition and Jeannot's DNA, and bring them together with modern materials and contemporary woodwork. It's really that combination that they were able to bring to the interior design of the boat that really set it apart from what has come before. The central galley is a key feature of the Sun Odyssey 440. By placing it here in the middle of the boat, it's an area that moves the least when the boat is underway or even at anchor. It has direct access to the saloon, direct access out to the cockpit, easy to brace and to hold oneself in here underway. Lots of storage built in, so this great storage cabinet here in the middle with lots of drawers. We have a refrigeration unit here. We have a nice stove and oven combination, which is easily ventilated with the hatch just above it. And we have here a kind of an innovative feature with the microwave. The microwave comes up on a lift, so it's there when you need it, and when you don't need it, very easy to put away and increase your countertop space. The chart table is a truly best-in-class feature on this boat. It's a great amount of space, a nice size desk. We have a little bit of we have a pen holder here, nice deep desk for all of your books and everything, and lots of storage throughout, small niche storages for your keys and other items on the boat. We've developed a nice set of clocks and barometers that are all signed Jeannot Sun Odyssey on the boat, and a centralization of all of the command functions of the boat, from a new touchscreen here giving you water, fuel, battery levels, or touch panel with all of the instrumentation, music, charging for USB and so forth. So really a real focus on making this a space that you can sit, be part of the life on board the boat, and have a place that is your command chair on board. Jean-Marc Piéton, in the interior design of the boat, played on two key elements to create one of the best forward cabins in her category. The first was to shift the head compartment slightly aft, giving it the space to have both a large head and a separate shower, and removing it a little bit from the forward cabin area. And of course, the combination of that with the wider hull section forward gave us an incredible cabin, a fully rectangular berth, 1.60 meters wide, 2 meters long. In fact, all of the berths on the boat are rectangular, so it's really just like at home. Very easy access to both sides, large hull ports looking out, a mirror at the front, and lots of storage, whether that be under the bed with big pull-out drawers or the full block of furniture here in the forward cabin. There was a real desire in the interior design to sort of change some of the rules. We made an asymmetrical forward bulkhead, which allows us to have the central galley, the big shower for the forward area of the boat, and to create a much cozier saloon area here in the central part of the boat. So it was very interesting to move some of these elements around to give it a much better feel down below. In addition to the way that the boat was laid out, a lot of the materials and woods, you could see here we have a possibility of having a material here on the wall, which gives you a much softer feel. We could also have it finished in the wood. The wood that we developed for this range can be in the traditional teak that we've always done our Sun Odysseys in, or in this new wood, which is a gray cedar, which gives it a very nice warm feel. And all of that married up with a very wide selection of modern and contemporary fabrics throughout the boat. In addition, there was a lot of design work gone into creating an environment on board that made the least amount of noise. So you see leather lining of the furniture, you see the fabrics on the bulkheads. There are even sound mats there in the bottom of the cabinetry, which create a space that as you move around and live on the boat, you create less noise for the others that are on board. And the last point of the interior, and it is really something that is it's worth seeing to believe, is the amount of light and ventilation that is created in this space. You can see long hull ports, long coach roof windows, lots of opening hatches, lots of opening ports, even in the aft areas of the boat, which are often neglected in that point. There is a ton of natural light, ventilation, and really a space of openness throughout the boat. In keeping with the theme of easy circulation, you can see that the forward cabin has the big double doors, which opens up the space. The entire flooring is done at one level, so there are nothing to step over, not even the door sills. Plenty of handholds, handrails, and fiddles throughout the boat, and this very gentle companionway, which makes coming in and out very easy. Thanks for taking the time to visit the new and exciting Sun Odyssey 440. A boat that is really redefining the way that you move around on board, that we've given you a full feature interior with a little bit of a twist, and we've tried to perfect the sailing experience on all of the different programs of navigation. Come and see the boat at the boat shows, and if you need any additional information, you'll find it on our website at journeau.com.